How and when to rebubble a DMEK graft. A video review of indications for rebubbling and ergonomic technique for rebubbling at the slit lamp. Brought to you by Chris Salas, Mike Strico, and Mark Terry. The authors have no financial conflicts of interest to disclose. In 2013, Mellis and colleagues published a paper in ophthalmology, which among other things showed that detachments less than one-third of the total area of a DMEK graft, not in the visual axis, resolved by 6 months or remained stable. This was the paper that established the one-third benchmark for rebubbling a DMEK graft. In 2014, Price and colleagues published 5-year follow-up data in the Journal of Cataract and Refractive Surgery. Their findings included that DMEK grafts bubbled once did not exhibit a statistically significant decline in endothelial cell counts compared to DMEK grafts that were not rebubbled at all. As a fellow with Mike Strico and Mark Terry at Devers Eye Institute, I developed a technique to bubble DMEK grafts at the slit lamp. We published this technique in Cornea in 2016. Later that year, Mellis and colleagues published another paper in Cornea on rebubbling DMEK grafts and an operative microscope. Their paper showed that DMEK grafts could be approached safely from a paracentesis adjacent to a detached part of the DMEK graft, or from paracentesis adjacent to a non-detached part of the DMEK graft, depending on the size and depth of the detachment. Now let's review a few illustrative cases. Case 1. Detachment less than one-third of the total area of the DMEK grafts, or localized pump deficiency. In this example, the one-week OCT shows that the overall cornea is compacting quite well, with only one small area of detachment in one frame, which amounts to less than one-third of the entire graft. The area of detachment, as denoted by the red arrows, can be thought of as an area of localized pump deficiency. However, since the rest of the cornea is compacting quite well, as denoted by the green arrows, particularly centrally, this detachment can be observed. 1 week later, the detachment is almost completely resolved. Let's go on to case 2, a detachment greater than one-third of the total area, or diffuse pump deficiency. In this example, the 1 week OCT shows not only multiple areas of DMEK graft detachment, as denoted by the red arrows, but diffuse stromal edema in multiple frames, as denoted by the purple arrows. There is not one area of compacting cornea, there is only diffuse pump deficiency. Turns out that this patient was not adherent with the position requirements after surgery. Given the extent of the corneal edema, it was decided to rebubble him with 20% SF6, which is usually not required. 10 days later, however, his cornea had made a very good recovery. Case 3. Corneal edema and or detachment affecting vision. In this example, the 1 week OCT shows central compacting with the cornea as denoted by the green arrows. It also shows a small area of detachment amounting to less than one-third of the total graft as denoted by the red arrows, and then several areas of paracentral, very mild corneal edema as denoted by the purple arrows. By the guidelines, this patient did not meet criteria for rebubbling, but she was disappointed with her vision and her progress by the second week after surgery. After much discussion, we decided to rebubble her, and 1 day later, she had made significant recovery of her vision. Case 4, another example of edema and/or detachment affecting vision. In this example, the 1 week OCT shows multiple frames of diffuse stromal edema, as denoted by the purple arrows. Nowhere, however, is there a single area of DMEK graft detachment. Nevertheless, this graft was rebubbled at 1 week, not because of the detachment greater than one-third or detachment affecting the visual axis, but because of diffuse pump deficiency. 1 week after the rebubble, the cornea had made a significant recovery. In summary, you should consider rebubbling a DMEK graft when the detachment is greater than one-third, when the detachment affects the visual axis, and when the patient has grown frustrated or impatient with the trajectory of the cornea's recovery. Put another way, you should consider rebubbling a DMEK graft when the graft is unhappy because of diffuse pump deficiency, when the patient is unhappy, and of course, only when the graft is right side up. Rebubbling at the slit lamp is easier on the patient and easier on the surgeon because it eliminates the need for a trip to the minor procedure room. The procedure is safe and effective at the slit lamp because the slit lamp affords visualization under high magnification and slit beam illumination. When the procedure is performed with an IV extension tube, the ergonomics are excellent. To rebubble at the slit lamp, you will need a 27-gauge cannula, standard IV extension tubing, and a Lurelock 5 or 10cc syringe filled with air. Assembling the rebubbling apparatus is easy. Simply attach one end of the IV extension tubing to the Lurelock syringe and the other end of the IV extension tubing to the 27-gauge cannula. The eye is prepared in the usual sterile fashion, and the infratemporal paracentesis is opened by scratching the epithelium with forceps. For a right eye, the surgeon's left hand manipulates the cannula. The surgeon's right hand maneuvers the joystick to maintain focus and simultaneously depresses the syringe once the cannula is in the correct position. The cannula is inserted into the anterior chamber and advanced beyond the area of detachment so that the tip of the cannula is behind a part of the DMEK graft that is fully attached. Once the tip is in this position, the shaft of the cannula is used to depress the posterior aspect of the wound and thereby release aqueous from the anterior chamber and create space for the bubble that's going to be placed. When the plunger is depressed, a bubble is then released into the anterior chamber, which then expands from the area of the DMEK graft that is attached toward the area of the DMEK graft that is detached, thereby ironing out that detached area as it expands.
Thanks for your attention.